What is up, everybody? Welcome into TechExpress once again. In today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to connect Meta Facebook into your actual Shopify. So the very first thing you want to do, let's go directly into the point. What I want to do is to open two new tabs. Into the very first tab, I need to have my Shopify account, and into the other one, I wanted to have my contact of the actual Gmail. If I don't want to have my Gmail enabled, I can open a new tab and look out for the business. Meta business suite. So go directly into business.facebook.com, and this one should be taking you into the dashboard inside your actual account. So let's go and log in with Facebook or with Instagram, depending on what is the element that you want to choose. I'm gonna go for logging with Instagram. And once I am here, what I want to do is to now go back into Shopify, just leave the tab already been opened. I'm gonna hit here. And then what I wanted to do is to look out for the application tools, and I'm going to hit into add application. Here what I wanted to do is to scroll all my way down and look out for the app store inside Shopify. If you don't find that, you can open a new tab and open apps.shopify.com. Once we are in here, what I wanted to do is to look out for Meta. So here into the Meta, you're going to be showing that there's a lot, but really, really a lot of tools in order to add the business of the Facebook. So I click here into Facebook and Instagram, and it says free to install, additional charges may be applied, the rating, the DBU, and the developer. So what you want to do is to make sure that the developer is called Meta, or go directly into Meta so you can see that there's a lot of applications, only there's only one of them. Because there's a lot of people who can be helping you to do this, but there are lots of things that are going to be taking charges, and you don't want to pay actually for anything. I mean, nobody pays for making the installation of Meta into Shopify, so that's probably a scam. So you want to make sure that this one is the developer and created by Meta. So choose into the installation process, hit into add application, and then later on, I just need to grant the access from Shopify into my Facebook account. So let's go into add sales channel, because at the end of the day, this is a sales channel. So now, as you can see, we're now into Facebook and Instagram. I'm going to pin my actual application, and then it says start selling in Facebook and Instagram. What I want to do is to scroll a little bit down, and I can start the setup. So what I want to do is to connect my Shopify inside the Facebook account to get started. That's the reason why you want to have a new tab with your Meta business owner already been opened. So let's go back into Shopify, hit into connect account, and this one should be popping up this new login section of Facebook. So I'm going to hit now into continue, and we need to grant the access so we can choose the Facebook page we wanted to connect our actual store. If you don't have a Facebook page, you don't have to worry about that. What we can do is to go directly in here into the Meta business suite. I'm going to head down here, and I'm going to locate to create and actually manage a new business account, which in my case is in here. So what you want to do is to type your business account name, your first, your last name, your business email, and hit into create. So once you have successfully done that, you can look out for all the tools. You can go directly into the manage, go into view page, or into the page setting so you can create a new page. And then later on, once you have created a new page, you can go back into Shopify, choose the one that you have just created, and hit into connect. So then this is the reason why we needed to have a business account already been created into the Meta business suite. So I'm going to choose the one that I have just created, hit into select, and hit into connect. So this one should be taking just a few seconds, and then later on it's going to be asking for the checkout method. So where do we want our customers to complete their purchase? So you wanted to edit the payment settings and hit into continue, or choose the Shopify online store depending on how you wanted to get charged for. So I'm going to hit into save, and then later on it's going to be asking for the managing of the Facebook and the Instagram data sharing preferences. What I can currently just do is to use the enhanced one. So this one is going to be helping you to show it using Metapixels, so customers can disconnect this data from the Facebook account by changing their settings on the off Facebook activity. If we select the maximum one, this one is like getting the best possible results, so continually updated the Facebook latest advertising technology and shares the most data with Facebook. But I can totally suggest that you stick around with engaged if you're just getting started. Hit into save, And lastly, I'm going to be choosing a pixel to track the customer behavior. So what I wanted to do is to either create a new one or to choose the one that we have just created before. What I can generally suggest to, I can strongly suggest you to focus into one pixel at a time. So I'm going to create an actual new one, and then I'm going to hit now into confirmed. Why do I wanted to create a new pixel? Because this pixel, I wanted to be focused only into Shopify. I can go back into my Better Business Suit, and here I can go into my Event Manager. The Events Manager, you can find that into the all the tools, focus into Advertise and Events Manager. Here into the Events Manager, what I wanted to do is to look out for the pixels that I have created. So if I have a one with my actual name, I can change the name of that pixel. Wait, let's say, for example, instead of choosing only my name, I only choose Shopify, for example. So I can go and choose my pixel in the data sources. I'm going to hit into the X mark. I'm pretty sure that we created this one. So instead of going for this name, I'm going to delete this and I'm going to go for Shopify clients and hit into save. So this way, I know that all of this actual information, all the tests, the diagnostics, the analytics, everything comes directly from Shopify. So I am just focusing into Shopify. So then later on, I can go back into Shopify once again. I need to agree to the Facebook terms of service and hit submit for review. What's going to be now left to do here is to make the finalization of the channel setup. This might be taking a minute or two, so you don't have to be discouraged if you are not into the progress. But once this has been successfully done, we are now able to shop into Facebook. Now, either you are approved right away or you have the reviewing the Facebook sales channel. So what I want to do is to go into done, start the verification process into Facebook, and this one is going to be taking us into the business.facebook.com commerce manager. This one should be appearing because we don't have an actual Facebook shopping enabled yet. So that means that we don't have any catalog, we don't have anything in the shop, we don't have any ads, any promotion, anything into the actual business suit. So let's say that you have products into Shopify, but you need to have these products right away, of course, into the store of the actual Facebook. So what I want to do is to make the actual verification of myself, that I am the legit person and I have the entity documents in order to review the personnel and the government issued photo ID and all that. So I hit into next and I provide as much information as I can in order to get started selling stuff here into Facebook. And later on, you can start by adding products to start selling. If I hit into add my products, I don't have to worry about that because all my catalog is now been sourced into Shopify. And there you go. So this one is going to be taking me directly into Shopify. So we have now linked the actual business meta suit inside Shopify. What is left to be done is just to verify my account in order to import all of that elements inside my actual meta. And then later on, I can start to make some sales. I believe this process is a little bit more difficult, hard, it's going to be taking a few times, but I think we have now covered the basic of how we can get started here into the sales channel of the Facebook, Instagram, and Shopify at the same time. So with that being said, guys, I think we have now covered the basics, so don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more great tools of how you can import, download, and install applications of Shopify. Thank you so much for watching the video, and well, I'll see you on the next video.